All right, let's start from the beginning. So what is WebSockets in the first place? The idea is that WebSockets is a communication protocol that is designed for clients and servers to talk to each other. But there's a long history of how this has already been implemented in the web and the internet and the networks. And actually, the WebSocket protocol actually lives on top of a super, super standard protocol called the HTTP protocol, the Hypertext Transfer Protocol, which is basically the protocol on top of which the whole internet and all the websites that you can think of right now online, they work on, okay? The idea is that regular HTTP is very good for websites because the content and the interaction model that you typically require when you access a website is very static in nature. The idea is that when you want a website, the client, which is you or your browser, access some server, typically the website that you type in or whatever domain name server is being assigned to your request, whatever. And when you reach that server, you basically request to be served some information. That information is typically HTML code, so the code that runs the website. Then the server sends that information back to you. And then your browser takes that HTML, renders it, and then it shows you a website. This is the super, super basic typical model on top of which 95% of the whole internet is built on. This is really good, and it works really well for static content where you don't really need a lot of interaction back and forth, because this interaction is based on the idea that you request the website to be sent to you, and then the server sends you that website back, and period. That's all interaction that you need. However, when you want to engage in communication that is more data intensive or is more real-time intensive, the HTTP protocol is very constrained, because since it requires this request and response cycle to be executed every time, so the connection needs to be established, the headers needs to be sent, blah, 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 whatever, it's actually not very optimal and not very fast. And also, for technical reasons that we're not going to get into, the connection between the client and the server, when these requests happen, are one-off connections. The connection doesn't stay alive. There is not a tunnel, if you will, that gets established between the client and the server, where communication is flowing in both directions. That is not how HTTP works. So WebSockets came in as a way of making this live, this real-time communication, this real-time data exchange between a client and a server much more optimal and faster by maintaining an active communication between the two agents in this communication part. So basically, WebSocket is an extension of HTTP. It uses HTTP underneath, but it supersedes it because what it does is that once an initial HTTP connection is established, so this process called handshake, which basically means the client and the server exchange a couple of headers saying like, hey, can you do WebSockets? Yes, I can do WebSocket. Which version of WebSockets will you? Let's agree to use 1.1. Okay, we're good. Handshake. And then the communication starts. And once the communication starts, there is a full duplex persistent communication between the two parties, the client and the server, which means that there is a tunnel or there's a highway where data can go in both directions without needing any kind of request. So the client can send data to the server without the server specifically asking for that data, and vice versa. The server can also send data back to the client without the client specifically asking for that data. This is very good because it makes data exchange and it makes the timing, the real-timeness of this data exchange very fast, which means that for real-time applications, it's a really, really good protocol. Very likely, if you have ever gone to a website that had some kind of chat window or where you can chat and you were chatting with an agent or with other people, etc., very likely that part of the website was implemented using WebSockets protocol, because it's a very standard protocol these days. And one of the very nice things about WebSocket as well is that it's a super, super standard protocol, which means that most programming languages that I can think of, or most frameworks that you might be working on, will be implementing some kind of WebSocket, will have some kind of WebSocket implementation that you will be using. Because WebSocket is not a JavaScript thing, or it's a Python thing, or it's a C-sharp thing. It's its own thing. It's a protocol that can be accessed using WebSocket, using JavaScript, Python, C-sharp, whatever language you can think of. It's kind of a, so if we have programming languages for computers, but we have protocols for ways of making machines talk to each other. This is all will be also really great because we will be able to use WebSockets as a communication protocol to make different softwares, so different different programming languages and different environments talk to each other. For example, we will be able to connect a JavaScript application with a Python application by connecting them with WebSockets. We will be able to make processing talk to Grasshopper, for example, by using a WebSocket server in between, etc., etc. So I don't have to disclose this, but it's one of my favorite protocols. It's super easy to implement. It's really fast. It's very nice. It's super playful, and it also allows. It will also allow this one thing that we can also not do with HTTP, which is not only will be able to do client-server communication on a one-to-one basis, but because there will be real-time communication flowing between the server and any client connecting to the server, what we will be able to do will be to connect multiple clients to the same server and then use the server as a way of exchanging data, broadcasting data that is coming from one client to the rest. Again, think of the chat window, that model. That is possible because the server has a live connection, not just with one of the clients, but with all of them. So we will be using that in the experiments that we will be looking at in this playlist, and it's going to be super fun and super flavorful, super playful. So let's move on to the next video and see how can we create a super simple WebSocket server. In this case, we're going to start doing it with Node.js and JavaScript. So let's first take a look at what Node.js is.